Hi, my name is Jeff from the Tinker Game Dev team, and today I'm going to show you how to make a randomly generated and colorful cityscape. Your result might look something like this. Cool. Now let's start drawing. First things, I want to go under this method pre-provided for you, and then make sure my indentation is correct, and then start importing. I want to import turtle because we're using turtle graphics to draw. And then import random because we want the cityscape to look different every time we run the program. Okay, now let's set up the turtle. T equals turtle.turtle. And then set the turtle speed to 0 because in turtle graphics, this is the fastest speed. Otherwise, it'll take eons for the turtle to finish drawing. Then let's set screen to the turtle screen. And then let's create some variables to store the screen left, right, top, and bottom, so it's much easier to position our turtle later. So screen left will be the negative of the screen window width divided by 2. And then screen right will be that, except positive. Similarly, for screen top, we're going to use window height instead. And for screen bottom, make sure it's negative. Cool, let's see if we have any errors. Great. Okay, we're done with this setup. Now we can start drawing up the background. Now let's choose some color schemes for our sky. So I like to use this website called coolers.co to help me make some really pretty color schemes. Now don't worry if you don't like the colors that you've got or you don't know how to make a color scheme. You can always adjust them like this. Or you can press spacebar to generate new color schemes. So I want to use this color scheme that I have from earlier. I'm going to use this red and this blue. Now let's first create some variables for those colors, sky color 1 and sky color 2. Go over here, click on the name, make sure we're in RGB mode, then copy that and put it inside parentheses to create a tuple data structure. Make sure they are in this RGB mode or this function provided up here won't work. Now you don't need to know how this function works, you just need to know that it takes two colors and blends them. So for example, if I give it sky color 1, sky color 2, and then a number 0.4 in the last one, it'll take 40% of sky color 2, blend it with 60% of sky color 1, and give us our final color. Okay, now after that, we can tell the program how many colors we want in our gradient. So for mine, I want 12. But remember, if you have more, it'll take longer to draw, but it'll be smoother. But if you have less, it'll be faster, but not as smooth. And after that, tell the turtle to take its pen up because we don't want any outlines in our program. Okay, now we can start looping and drawing the sky rectangles. So first I want to loop over grad colors because I'm going to draw that many rectangles in our gradient. And then I want to start drawing from the top left, which would be the turtle's position at screen left. Screen top. Now I want to move the turtle down a little bit each time, so I want to tell it to shift down by screen window height times our fraction of how far in the loop we are, which is our current loop index, or I, divided by our total number of loop times, or grad colors. Then I'm going to tell the turtle to set its fill color to, let's just use sky color 1 for now because we want to see if our rectangle is being drawn correctly. Tell it to begin its fill and then point to the right. Okay, now we can draw each individual rectangle. Since each rectangle is composed of two pairs of different sides, we only need to draw it once and then loop over that twice. So I want to go forward. Our screen's width because we're already pointing to the right. Turn right And then now we're pointing downwards, so we're going to go forward our screen's window height divided by how many colors we have. Now let's turn right again. So we're pointing the opposite direction of where we started, and now we can repeat. Let's pop out of the inner loop and then end the fill. Let's see if that draws correctly. Oh, looks like I made a typo. I gave it the wrong name. Okay, should be good now. Great, it's drawing those red rectangles, except we have these white lines in the middle. Now that's because our screen's height is not directly divisible by number our grad colors. So we need to change this by adding a 1 right here, which will mean it will overlap and make each of these rectangles one bigger to account for those small division errors. So now this should fill the entire screen. Great, there's no more lines. Now one more thing to do with these two loops. Let's make a new color variable and let's actually generate the gradient. So let's take sky color 1, sky color 2, and then we need to calculate our blend percentage. So we want it to be 0, or only sky color 1 up here, and then 1, or purely sky color 2 down here. So I'm going to copy this over, but there's one thing to be wary of, is that remember how loops in Python start from 0 in this using this range function. So this means this will go from 0 to 11 instead of 1 to 12. Which is good, except that means that up here, this will be 0 over 12, because we have 12 right here, and this will be 11 over 12. So that means we need to make this the same as how many times we're looping. So we get that 0 to 1, 0 over 11 to 1, 11 over 11. And then don't forget to change this to that, so we will actually have a gradient. Ooh, looks good. Now we're done with our background. We can do the sun. So again, we need to choose a color for our sun. I like this color, so I'm gonna make sure it's an RGB, then copy it, create another variable called sun color. Okay, and then let's make sure our indentation's completely to the left. Then set our fill to this color. And then make sure we are in the top right. I want to position the sun relative to this corner, so I'm going to do t.setPosition screen top minus, let's say like 70, screen right minus around 100. And then I want to begin the fill. Draw a circle of radius 60, end the fill, and let's see what that looks like. Ooh, looks good. Okay, now we can move on to drawing the skyline. So first I want to go back up to our color variables and add a new color, building color. And then I want to go to coolers, and I want to choose this darker blue as my building colors. Now let's go all the way to the bottom, and I want to set my turtle's position to the bottom left-hand corner of the screen, because I want to draw from left to right. And then I also want to create a variable called total width and set it to 0. So we need to keep track of our building's width, because they are all of random width. We need to know when to stop drawing. So because of that, the loop we want to use is a while loop. So while our total width is less than our screen's width, we can keep drawing. And then after that, I want to create an if-else block, because I want to sometimes draw a gap between the buildings, and then sometimes draw the buildings themselves, and sometimes not have a gap between them. So the first thing in the loop is to set the turtle's position, heading actually to 0. So we're pointing to the right. And then in this if-else block, I'm going to use the random function. I'm going to use random.randrange 0 to 10. This will give us a number between 0 and 9, so less than 10. See if it's greater than 5, and if it is, I'm going to draw a gap. So I'm going to create a variable called gap width, set that to a fraction of the screen's width. Let's say around 8 to 15%. So to do that, I'm going to use a function called random.uniform. This will take two numbers we give it and return random numbers between those two. And then I'm going to go forward by this amount. And then increment total width by that. Great. Now for the buildings, I'm going to need two variables. I'm going to need one called current building width. Set that to screen.window width. But I want to divide the screen into 5 or 8 parts randomly. So I'm going to do random.uniform again, except divide by, and then 5.0 and 8.0. Okay, and now we want our second variable to be current building height. In this case, I want it to be a fraction of the screen's window height. I want it to be around 20% to maybe like 75%. Random.uniform 0.2, 0.75. Cool. Okay, now we can tell the turtle to set its fill color to building color and then start the fill. Okay, so now since we are only drawing the left side, the top side, and the right side of the building, we don't need to use a loop, we can just tell it to draw three lines. So first, tell the turtle to point upwards, and then move forward by the current building height. Then turn right by 90 degrees, point right. Then move forward by current building width. Lastly, turn right again 90 degrees, point downwards, and finish this building off. Okay, now we can end our fill. Increment total height, total width by this amount. And let's see what that looks like. Ooh, great. Let's draw it again. See if we can get a different set of buildings. Oh yeah, I like this one better. Cool. So what if we wanted a different set of colors for our buildings instead of just one color? So we can easily do that. Let's first create two different building color variables like we did for a sky, building color 1, building color 2, comment out the original. Let's go back to coolers. I want to choose this one as my second color. I already have this one, so I'm going to copy that. Then put in building color 2, copy over what I have here for building color 1. And then go right before our fill, create building color, and set that to be the result of blending between the two randomly. So blend between building color 1, building color 2, and this time I'm going to use random.random, which will give me a random decimal number between 0 and 1. You could also do random.uniform 0.0 and 1.0. But this one's a good use. Let's try that. Ooh, looks good. It's really subtle, but it looks good. If you want to change the colors, you can. So, yeah, now that we have our basic cityscape done, see what you can do to extend this. Maybe you can use what you learned from the gradient to draw different size circles for the sun and make that a gradient. Or you can make the building colors a gradient too instead of just random. So those are all just possible using the power of code in Tinker. Well, that's all we have for now. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the next tutorial from Tinker.